member of the Pipes and Drums, and I'm more than happy to be here this evening to address this wonderful beast which was just marched in through the doors. So, in case you don't know, it's called a haggis, and the poem is called Hey Haggis, and it's written by Scotland's most famous and immortal bard, Robert Burns. Therefore, your honest, saucy face, great chieftain, or the pudding race, a boon am I attack your place, page, right, or fair. Weel are you worthy, all grace of lands, the air. A groaning treasure, there you fill your heavies like a distant hill. Your pen would help commend a mill in time of need, and through the pores the dews distill like amber bead. His knife, see rustic labor bit, to catch you up with ready slack. Trenching your gushing entrails blit, like oni ditched in ooh, what a glorious set. Warm, reeking, rich, then horn for horn, they'll stretch and strive till tack the hindmost, and on they drive till all their wheels swell kites, the live are bent like drums. And our good man makes like the eye. Be thanking Thomas, his heir that o'er his French argued, for all the all that would start a sue of fricassee, that would make us spew. When Patrick Scummer looked down with sneering, scornful view on sick a dinner, poor Dale Seymour his trash as feckless as a withered rash, the spindle shank, the kid whiplash, his knee, a net through bloody flood, or field to dash. Oh, how unfit. But mark the rustic haggis fed, the trenching. Mark the rustic haggis fed. I forget the rest. Trembling earth resounds his threat, clapping his wally heave of black. He'll mark it whistle with arms and legs and heat will snag like taps a thistle. Ye powers, what make mankind your care? And dish him out, there's no affair. Old Scotland wants nay skinking wear that chops in luggies. But if you wish a grateful prayer, hear
a haggis.
Hey! Hey! Hey!